Cool, ciao.
Hey everyone, this is Mike Rennick. I'm the team lead, the senior broker of Team Rennick. Welcome to the premier edition of Out and About with Mike. My guest today is Mr. Stephen Reed. Steve is the owner and the publisher of the Longboat Key News.
Hey, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you and also the Sarasota City News.
That's correct.
Yeah. So we're in a noisy area, but there's a reason for that. We're on an area between downtown Sarasota and St. Armand's called Coon Key. And that's a name a lot of folks haven't heard of. But Steve, why are we here? What's going on?
Well, there's a lot going on. I mean, on one hand, there's a lot going on. We're building, the city of Sarasota is building what's called a MRT, a multi-use recreational trail. And that's where we're standing.
And behind us, we can see the barrels and the sidewalk.
Yes, we can. I mean, here's the goal. City of Sarasota is trying to accomplish two things. They're trying to make transportation more efficient between the islands and St. Armand Circle, which is right there in downtown Sarasota.
So this would be pedestrian traffic, walking, biking, things like that?
Yes, but it's all part of the big master plan. We're okay. Going to have the roundabout on the other end of Wrigley.
We have to come back and do a session on the roundabout.
We will. And all through the area, they're trying to connect it using these MRTs, multi-use recreational trails, which is really sort of a bloated sidewalk. It's a 10-foot wide sidewalk on both sides, the north and south side, and it allows easier pedestrian travel. It allows bicyclists to connect. This didn't exist prior, so what would happen is you had a rickety sidewalk in the old days, and the Coon Key Bridge will soon be replaced. Well, in the next 5 years will be replaced, and then you'll have unimpeded mobility. One thing to remember is 35,000 cars a day go over the bridge, pass by here either way. And with the new bridge, this has become one of the biggest recreational areas in the region.
So they started work sometime back past spring, is that correct?
No, they actually start, all right, government moves slowly. They're not like realtors. They don't sell the property and close in 90 days, cash only. The government works like 10 thumbs.
Okay.
So what they did was they started in October 2019.
Wow.
And they said it'll take 11 months to finish.
Okay.
So here we are in January 2021, and we're still...
There's not a lot of work left to
do. Not a lot, but here's the total scope of the project. It first started when all these Australian pines fell after Irma. So they removed the Australian pines. They pulled them all out of both sides of the road. Then they've widened the sidewalk just to our left, just to the north of this trail. They replaced a big water main along the whole way. That took a lot of time. Yep. It was an old water main. So then they put in these sidewalks, and then they're going to plant 200-300 trees. They say it's going to be almost like a botanical garden along here.
Okay.
And so that'll be something really lovely. They're trying to make this a signature entrance to the island.
It is, yes.
So that is the goal. I think it's going to be beautiful when it's done. Right now it's more opened up than it will be.
We can come back and we can update folks as there's more progress. But before we close, I want to change the subject for just a little bit. We didn't rehearse this, but you and I are wearing something today that most Floridians don't get much use out of. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, jackets.
You're wearing
it's
a
cold.
Jacket and I'm wearing a sweater. So for all the folks up north, it's in the 40s right now, which I know you don't feel sorry for us. I get that.
Yeah.
But we've had a little bit of cooler weather. So, Steve, I want to thank you for helping me kick off this series. You'll be part of the weekly guest. I appreciate that. We are going to continue to tell the story of the west coast of Florida.
Correct.
From the eyes of the folks that live here, play here, and work here. Thanks for watching, everyone.